This video will include instructions on how to operate your Benyar chronograph watch. This one happens to be model BY5140M. Let's talk about the function of the chronograph on this particular watch. So as you can see, we have a top pusher and a bottom pusher. This watch has three subdials. So the subdial here at the 12 o'clock position is a 1/10 second counter. The subdial at the 6 o'clock position is a 60 second counter, and the subdial at the 9 o'clock position is a 60 minute counter. So let me go ahead and just reset this real quick for you. Okay, so now we're back to zero. So to operate this chronograph, you simply press this top pusher once, and that will start the chronograph. And then to stop it, you push it again, and then to reset it, you push the B or bottom pusher. So let's go ahead and start it. And you will see that top pusher activates the chronograph. And as you can see, this one spinning around here is a 1/10 second counter. For every full rotations, it's actually measuring 2 seconds. So it's 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4 second. The subdial at the 6 o'clock is our second counter, and you can see that moving in seconds. And then our subdial here at the 9 o'clock is a 60 minute counter. Now this will start to slowly advance as this comes around to 60. So right now you can kind of see it starting to move. And as this small second hand comes around to 60, this should be at a 1 minute mark. Now this top counter here is only gonna spin for a minute. And after a minute, it stops spinning. It's still counting, but it just doesn't physically spin. So you'll see that stop here once we hit the 60 second mark. There it goes. So you can see that this top has stopped, but the bottom second counter is still going. And our minute timer is showing a minute. So this is just elapsed time. So to stop it, I'm gonna go ahead and push this top pusher again. Now what that does is stop the small second hand down here. So it looks like we are at 15, 16, 17, 18, I guess 18, looks like 18 seconds. Now, this is a little confusing. Because this is actually counting every 2 seconds, it's not printed that way. So it's printed as if this is rotating once for every 1 second. And that's not the case, because you can see the 1, 2, or the, you know, the 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 for 1/10 seconds. But in reality, half of this subdial is for 1 second, and the other half is for the second second. So right now, I guess this, on display, this is showing maybe 8.75 according to the display, because this tick mark right there would be 9, and then we're back to 10 or 0 here. But in reality, this is actually, we're going to count the tick marks, because there's 10 tick marks per side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it looks like we're at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and a half. So we're actually at 0.75 seconds, not the 8.75. So hopefully that makes sense and it's not too confusing for you. It's just that this subdial is not, it just didn't print it properly. This would make sense if it spun around 1/10 of a second, you know, for 1 second increments, but it's actually counting 2 second increments. So it's a little bit confusing. And I don't know why, I don't know how Benyar missed that, but they did. Okay, to go ahead and reset it, we're gonna go ahead and push this bottom pusher, and everything should reset back to zero. And we're gonna see that, yep, there we go. Now, this second hand is not lined up perfectly. I did mess around with it a little bit, but I think that's about the best I can do. But I'm gonna show you how to reset these also a little bit later in the video. Now, the other thing that you can do with this chronograph is that you can push your top button, and we can stop it. And we can push it again, and it will just continue. So if you were, I think this is called elapsed time. If you were, I guess, timing, let's say like a basketball game or something, and you didn't want to include the timeouts or the breaks or anything like that, you could stop it. And then once the game resumes, you can push it again. Again, to reset, you're just going to push this bottom pusher and it will reset. Now, the other feature on this chronograph that maybe some people don't realize is that it can also do split times. And I'm not sure exactly why you'd want to measure split times or, you know, what function that has. But you would go ahead and start it by using the top pusher. And I'm going to stop it with the bottom pusher. So watch what happens. I'm going to stop. Let's just get to 15 seconds here. And I'm going to push it. Now it stopped. But it didn't really stop. So when I start it again, I'm going to go ahead and push this B button again. And you're going to see this small second hand kind of jump. You ready? See how it jumped? So now it's back on track. So we didn't lose any time. So I guess this is called split time. So maybe down in the comments, someone can tell me what we would use this for. I'm not exactly sure. And I can do that multiple times. So I stopped it. And if you let it go long enough, you'll see it jump again. I'm going to go ahead and start it again. And we're back to our, we haven't lost any time. Now you see that that's that 1/10 counter stopped because it's been past a minute. And you can see that this is advanced. So now we're going to go ahead and stop it for real, top button. And we can measure our lapse time here, which is 1 minute, 10 seconds. And again, we got to count the tick marks. 1, 2, 3. So it's about 0.35 seconds. And we're going to reset it with the B. Okay, now what happens with chronographs, a lot of times that these don't reset properly, usually a function of a battery change will cause that, or if they just get out of whack, I guess. So let me show you how to reset those. It's real easy. Okay, so I purposely put these subdial counters in weird positions here. So we can see that we're going to go ahead and start the chronograph. And I'm going to stop it, and we're going to reset, and you're going to see it's not going to reset properly. There we go, right? So our 1/10 counter is set down here, our minute's off, and our second is off. So like I said, usually we see this during a battery change or if things just kind of get funky. So how do we fix that? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to pull the crown to position 2, which is time setting position, okay? And then we're going to use our pushers. So this top pusher controls this top subdial right here. So as I push this, you see it moving? So I can put it back to 0. Now you can either do single pushes or you can push and hold and you'll see it spin. And we're going to go ahead and set that back to 0 right there. Now the bottom pusher is going to control actually both of these subdials. So you can't control this 60-minute counter individually. It's actually tied to this one in the gearing, I believe. So we can fix the bottom one. So again, we can push them singly here for 1 second increments or push and hold. Now, because my minute is off quite a bit here, I'm going to push and hold. And as I push and hold, you're going to start to see this minute start to move as well. See how that's moving? So I'm going to keep going until I get that minute close to 59. And then I will be, I don't want to overshoot it here. And let's just go single increments here until we get to 60. And like I said, this second hand was not perfect. It's a little bit off by maybe a half second. So I can either go there, which looks pretty close, or I can go one more. That puts it there. I think that looks like it's too much. So unfortunately, if I want to fix that, now I got to go all the way around again. So I won't do that to you here in the video. But that's what you would need to do. Let me go ahead and stop it. Okay, because I overshot it there, I'm going to redo this for you. And I'm getting down to within my minute. And I'm going to leave it, looks like maybe 59 and a half. I think that looks better than the other position. Now I'm going to go ahead and push my crown back in. And we're going to go ahead and test the function. I'm going to go ahead and let this go past a minute and just show you what it's going to look like. All right, I let this run a little bit longer, and I'm going to go ahead and stop it, and we're going to reset it. Now, it does take a while to reset because this second hand has to come around, but now we're back to all of our zero positions, so we successfully reset this chronograph. And for those that are interested in the watch, just some quick dimensions here. The bezel diameter is 45 millimeters. Including the crown, it's about 48 millimeters, and lug to lug is 50 millimeters, and the overall height is about 13. It does have a domed mineral crystal. I bought this one on the steel bracelet, and I think it'll look nice on a leather band or leather strap. It's a little, maybe a little bit big for my wrist. I have about a 7-inch wrist. So there it is. It's a little bit heavy, a little bit clunky, but for the price on Amazon, not sure you can beat it, especially if you like the look of the Tag Heuer Carrera. I think that's what this dial really looks like, and even the logo, they kind of got a similar logo, right? This is the black version with the black bezel, and I believe it's offered in different dial colors as well. So there you go. If you have any questions, leave them down below. And thank you for watching.